Good morning, welcome back to Your Tech News in 5 minutes or less, making headlines this week. The 10700 and 10600K geek big scores come out. We see the Z490 leaks more than the fire pools at Encantla. New AMD B450 boards will land in June. And Crysis returns to break PCs under the people's elbow. Welcome back to Your Tech News in 5 minutes or less. Two announcements before we get underway. EVTech has reopened their doors as of the 20th of April, and they are going to be prioritizing people that need office goods, etc. It's not for luxury purchases, guys. It is an essential services opening to help those that need RMA and warranty, etc., to carry on doing their work, and that will be the primary function of the reopen. Luxury goods are still going to be put on hold until after the lockdown is officially over. And then secondly, we had the Intel 10th Gen is Here competition launch with the Dell, where you guys get to put together your own videos on your favorite feature of the new 10th Gen lineup. Personally, as a Top Gear top tip, that battery life and flexibility of power is going to be phenomenal on the 10th Gen. So maybe put in a little bit of time there. Also gaming, guys, single core performance is going to be up. We're going to see 5 gigahertz on some of the top end guys. So there's a couple of pointers for you guys to get going and join us and enter that competition. Moving on to some good guy news around the COVID-19 stuff. AMD has given $15 million worth of their EPIC server power over to COVID-19 researchers. And basically, in layman's terms, what that means is they've given over multiple Threadrippers, multiple upon multiple Threadrippers, $15 million worth. That's a lot of Threadripper, with each one costing, you know, in the region of $1,000, $1,200 to $1,500 USD. That's like 100 chips. So it's not like a thousand chips. Sorry, my math is terrible. So there's a huge amount of compute power that Auntie Lisa has given over to COVID-19 researchers. Thank you so much, Andy. Good job on you. I mean, it's only like a couple of Bugattis that have been sandwiched together to basically turn the world. In Intel news, we saw, as I said, more 10700K and 10600K benchmarks coming out. Something that was really nice that I did notice, okay, while they did pip the 3800X and 3600 respectively, if only just in the multi-core, the single core on the 10600K is looking really, really promising for the gamers. It even beat out its 10700K counterpart. Now, these are obviously done with hyper-threading, without optimizations, etc. But I must say, at 1080p, if you're looking for a chip, 10600K is probably going to be the one on your radar, because it's hitting 4.8 gigahertz boost all by itself. So hopefully there is a little bit of overclocking headroom. It does seem like Intel has eaten it up, if the 9900K is anything to go by. The board partners have also leaked all of the Z490 goodness. We can see a number of boards coming out. Most of them do look the same spec wise, etc. Everything is looking very familiar or very similar to the Z390s. Now, this is obviously only going to be for Comet Lake S chips. So if you are wanting one of those, it does mean you are going to have to upgrade your motherboard. But I did notice two that looked particularly good. There's some facelifts happening on the tough side with Asus. Theirs looks a far sight better than their previous generation did, so good job there. And then that MSR MPG Mag Wi-Fi Z390M, it just looks really, really clean and neat and pretty. I do quite like that a lot. In AMD news, there's talk of a B450 coming as early as June 16th, which will feature PCI Express 4.0. Now, this with a Ryzen 3600 is going to be incredibly hard to beat bang for buck wise. If you guys are looking to do some maybe crossover work and gaming, 6-core 12 thread, it's something to laugh at. Those little chips are absolute monsters. At least in our tests, we got very, very close to what I had on an 1800X performance wise. So that's looking very promising. Their 4800U also got a couple of interesting benchmarks done with their new Vega core setup. So while they have dropped a couple of cores, and as we mentioned, they will start at 4 and end at 8 in our last episode, we mentioned that this would be the setup. We have some benchmark stats to have a look at with it. And basically, it's an MX250. So if you're looking at a dedicated GPU setup versus something that's all in core for 35 watts, the AMD is going to get way better battery life than two components running simultaneously, quite obviously, because there's just less wattage involved running it all off chip, and it's got better RAM support, and we know the AMD's plus faster RAM always equals a better performance score. And then because they've dropped the core count, but it's on 7nm, they've increased the boost clocks and the, well, the base clocks of the GPU that's built into it. And in a nutshell, basically, it's a 750 Ti that's coming on chip, so you'll even be able to do some light gaming. But for those that are just into media and perhaps design on the go, this is going to be absolutely phenomenal. Lastly, in cool things that are cool, we do see Crysis Remastered is coming back. It's back. It's here to break PCs all over again. And we finally get to, well, or continually get to ask the question, but can it run Crysis? The remaster should include the Warhead expansion as well, which is just really, really cool. And we will be getting a copy of that as soon as possible to see our 50 FPS benchmark scores. And to keep comfy while we are waiting for that benchmark result, we'll have ourselves a seat in the Cougar Gaming Couch, available in four different colors. We'll take two for podcasts, please, sirs. Unfortunately, though, that is all we have time for today. So keep your lives ticking and your games raking. We'll see you next time.